Now he backs Lewis with something, a good right hand. A big chin. Good uppercut again. Two punches inside by Lewis. And you know,
and I gotta wonder how much nervousness. Here comes Ray Mercer.
Mercer really piling it on here. Good shot by Mercer.
Mercer
needs
an uppercut.
Some speed with it here. Some good speed and power by Mercer. Back comes Lewis. What a war. Go back to the Marion Wilson fight where he had more on the line. And he got out of the referee and will bring the fighters together. Talk about fair play a little bit here. Mercer hit.
And Mercer started to get up one good shot, even though he's getting pounded.
Well, this was a good round for Lennox Lewis, especially the last part. Round 7 is history.
Pertandingan tinju kelas berat profesional antara Lennox Lewis versus Ray Mercer, yaitu pada tanggal 10 Mei tahun 1996 di Madison Square Garden Las Vegas, Amerika Serikat. Meskipun Lennox Lewis telah menjadi favorit pada pertandingan ini dan mendapat bayaran sebesar 1,2 juta US dollar, dan Ray Mercer menghasilkan 400 ribu US dollar. Tetapi Ray Mercer berhasil mengejutkan Lennox Lewis dan penonton yang menyaksikan langsung jalannya pertandingan ini, yaitu dengan bolak-balik menunjukkan pertarungan terbuka yang saling baku hantam sejak dimulainya bel ronde pertama pada pertandingan ini. Namun ronde keempat merupakan ronde yang paling mengesankan pada pertandingan ini.
Get anything off in there as Lewis.
By not moving his head, Lennox Lewis is
trying to run through Lennox Lewis rather than bob and weave and work his way through. He wants to get inside so badly.
And you can't miss Ray Mercer's head. No movement from the knees up.
It's also the style of a guy who... That's the first big battle, getting inside the jab.
He heard him.
He scores. Mercer backing Lewis up. Lewis holding on. Good right, chopping right by Mercer. Uppercut. Lewis in trouble. Coming right by Mercer again. Really heating up nicely. Mercer and Lewis come to the end of round two.
Lewis was, from a skill standpoint, working on his balance, learning to put his punches together. We haven't seen it thus far. Lewis, also another heavyweight who's gone through a succession of trainers. He's on his third one.
Well, Mercer coming back strong behind the missed jab by Lewis and scores with the right hand. And Mercer's right hand has been a good weapon thus far as round three finishes up.
Namun ronde keempat merupakan ronde yang paling mengesankan pada pertandingan ini, di mana di awal dan di pertengahan ronde keempat ini, Lennox Lewis berhasil memukul Ray Mercer dengan beberapa kombinasi pukulan yang sangat mengesankan. Tetapi pada 40 detik waktu tersisa di ronde keempat ini, Ray Mercer berhasil menampilkan serangan terbaiknya dalam pertarungan ini. Tetapi pada 40 detik waktu tersisa di ronde keempat ini, Ray Mercer berhasil menampilkan serangan terbaiknya dalam pertarungan ini, yaitu dengan memukul Lennox Lewis lewat 16 pukulan kombinasi terbaiknya yang sejenak membuat Lennox Lewis tercengang. Sebelum Lennox Lewis kembali maju meresponnya dengan melepaskan beberapa pukulan kombinasinya lagi. Di setiap ronde pada pertarungan ini, Lennox Lewis dan Ray Mercer terlihat bolak-balik melakukan pertukaran pukulan dengan tidak ada orang yang mendapatkan knockdown. Hingga bel ronde terakhir dibunyikan, tanda pertarungan telah usai.
Left hook by Lewis from the outside. Well, Mercer's Mercer continues to fire the left hook as he gets inside the cement chin of the heavyweight division without question. And Mercer proceeds. Devices used to try to reduce the swelling there, which Ray Mercer.
He had gobs of Vaseline dripping from his cheekbones. Right away, you could see that they knew that was going to
happen. And Mercer with those slashing tight punches and heavy shots, he's been able to get those big bombs.
The guy's right in front of you. Just four punch combination, you do something. Now he's getting hit because he's outside, not doing anything.
Well, two right hands by Lennox Lewis.
And Lewis starting to move as well. And then the left hook by Lewis. And Lewis starting to put some punching and movement. Same point in the fight. He's done some very good work through the five rounds. But Lewis trying to turn it on. Mercer always dangerous, though. And lands an uppercut and a left hook. Now he backs Lewis up in a good right hand. A big chance for
Mercer.
Got
it. He rocked him.
He needs to capitalize on these chances, which we talked about earlier. There may not be too many.
Heaviest of his career. He does have a big frame, obviously, 6'5". Looks like he carried the weight fairly well, but you got to wonder what effect that's having on his conditioning.
Sounds like he's
6 and both guys have their moments. Some big bombs, come back. Round 7 scheduled for 10.
A little bit more. And then what happened? Ray Mercer came back with those right hands and uppercuts.
And you know, with Ray Mercer's heart, he will be back. If he's got the conditioning, he will take the shots he's got.
He learned something, though, with Ray Mercer.
Good right hands here now. Mercer coming along and Lewis holding. Lewis pouring it on. These guys take turns going at each other.
Every chance to knock him out. He gets inside, doesn't keep his hands up, and Mercer's trying to get up one good shot, even though he's getting pounded.
Well, this was a good round for Lennox Lewis, especially the last part. Round 7 is history. Now, did Lewis steal things here at the end of the 7th? Good clubbing right hand. Goes downstairs. Nice uppercut. 5 shots.
Unanswered.
All right.
Well, now we know what our preferences are as judges.
John Saraceno likes the inside style. Tony, possibly the judges might have that same change in opinion there.
There's Lennox Lewis giving
the win. Maybe by 2 or 3 to get the nod. And over the course of her career, a lot of these decisions come full circle. We go back to the Marion Wilson fight where he had more on the line and he got the call. And now the referee will bring the fighters together. Talk about fair play a little bit here. Mercer hits off the break nicely.
Lennox Lewis is hurt.
1988.
And now they find themselves in this matchup. At critical stages of their careers, 8 years later, Mercer trying to save his, and Lennox Lewis trying to save a date with Mike Tyson, clubbing right by Lennox.
Make an argument for either guy. It's that close.
It is a close fight.
And Lewis on the outside here, Mercer continuing to pound. Good jab, uppercut by Lewis. And we start the 9th round. Ray Mercer, Lennox Lewis, 2 rounds to go. Dave Fontempo, along with Tony Page and John Saraceno, years, came up with a very close one over Marion Wilson to Larry Holmes in some big moments. And a point you made, John, about him being a better underdog seems to have come true again tonight. Well, we start the final round, and both corners sense how Ray Mercer has to suck up whatever he's got now. Double jab, get in. And make it the inside rumble that it was earlier.
And Davey,
not a bad idea by Lewis to stay outside. One within his grasp, still may get it. But in the last 2 or 3 rounds, has faded.
And he got rock. Lewis got rock coming in.
An excellent heavyweight battle. A crowd pleaser. They might even get up on their feet when this is over. They should.
Namun setelah pertarungan usai ketika penghitungan poin dilakukan, Lennox Lewis dinyatakan sebagai pemenang pada pertandingan ini. Dengan satu hakem memberikan hasil imbang bagi kedua petinju, yaitu dengan angka 95-95. Dan dua hakem lagi memberikan kemenangan kepada Lennox Lewis, yaitu dengan angka 96-95 dan 96-94 untuk kemenangan Lennox Lewis.